worth us sort of taking that stretch to see if we can make it happen.
First down and 10 for the Minutemen at the 34-yard line. And they'll get it out on the edge. Nice job here. This is Isabella, and he's able to get up to the 44, almost the first down. We'll see if they give it to him, 8 of 10. Now, how about scheduling overall? I mean, the difficulty being an independent and having to schedule these games, you know, you play some really tough opponents, and you're on the
road. UMass is trash.
How does all that happen?
Yeah, you've got to be creative, and that was one of the reasons why we decided to make the move for the AAC, because we're playing a lot of AAC schools, and we thought that that was a good partnership, a good way for us to look after them and make sure that that was good. But we haven't had any problems. We've got the schedule set for 19, we're close to finishing up 2020 and 2021, and feel good about the independent schedule moving forward.
Jacoby Perry on an 18-yard gain gets you that first down.
Now, Ryan, with that said, a lot of fans out there, they're hoping, and I know you are too, eventually
UMass gets into a conference. There's a lot of fans that believe the American is that place for them. I know it's not really in your control, but talk about long-range conference affiliation, if you will.
Any more new things on campus? What's getting put into the football program to help Coach Whipple in the recruiting process? Because as you know, it's what everyone has. You know, these kids look at the amenities. So what's going on with the UMass football program to help them out there?
Yeah, we've invested. You know, the last 3 years we've opened the Football Performance Center, a $40 million building that's as good as most Power 5 schools have. And investing now in our infrastructure with our stadium and looking in the next 2 to 3 years to build an indoor facility. That's kind of on the horizon for us. And really excited about the things going on around our football program, especially as it relates to some of the physical plants and the facilities.
Young gets stopped shy of the first down for UMass. Ball's at the 34-yard line of Temple. It's going to be fourth down, and they will go for it. Here as we talk with UMass Athletic Director Ryan Banford. And the Minutemen will see if they can convert, keep the drive alive, and they will. Nice play on the sideline, and that may draw a flag as well on a catch by Jesse Brett. First time tonight on the reception. It's a gain of 12, and it's just what UMass needed.
Well, and I thought it should have drawn a flag. It didn't, because 36 Sam Franklin for Temple threw the running back a little extra once he was out of bounds. That usually draws a flag. Player safety, we'll get a look at it here. He's out of there, which is good, but that last little throw could have drawn a flag. You understand what the officials look at, though. Sometimes the defender doesn't realize where the sideline is, so they let it go.
Play fake. Forward pressure again, and it's going to be the seventh sack of the night by Temple. Ryan, as we continue with, what this program, the university, has to do, just tell us about the challenges and the difficulty of moving from FCS to FBS and everything that goes on to be competitive. I don't think people understand how difficult it is.
Well, winning college football games has never been easy. You guys know that. But, building a winning culture is really the hardest thing, and really trying to turn the corner. And games like we had earlier this year against Hawaii, when you're up 2 touchdowns in the second half, closing games out here tonight, closing out that first half in a solid way, that goes towards winning, and that's the corner that we have to turn, and we haven't figured that out yet.
Young with a run to the 20-yard line. They are playing inspired here tonight, and they are looking really good defensively. UMass, they have that lead, 7-3. We saw that at the end of the first half, giving up those two late touchdowns. Let's hope, for your sake, and these guys, it turns around for you here in this game. Ryan, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me, guys. Appreciate
it. Great to see you again. Ryan Banford, the athletic director for the UMass Minutemen, is... They trail it here 19-7. Third quarter action coming up on 6 minutes to go. Driving here, Rainey, in a crucial third down. Forward to the end zone. That's a touchdown. Jesse Britt, the true freshman. First score of the season. UMass is right back in it.
Well, excellent protection up front. Temple tries to get pressure on Andrew Ford. They step up, they block, and keep Ford clean in the pocket. He can make some passes down the field, and he made one right there.
Nine plays, 66 yards, just over 4 minutes. Solid drive for UMass, capped up by that 20-yard touchdown reception. And the extra point makes it a 5-point game here in Philadelphia.
And that was the answer that UMass needed here in this third quarter. And trailing 19-14.